indeed also the first official event of the research cluster that I'm trying to get off the ground here at the Institute, which I've entitled Declassifying the Classics. I think the title came to me after watching Citizen 4. The cultural framework, ideology that this painting portrait conveys is one of rhetoric. You see Haydn at his tools, at the keyboard. His hand, his left hand is actually on the keyboard. His right hand is with the bow, and the pops on the left hand side of the piano is music. I mean, it's all real. You see the artist with his tools.
Right? You have experience playing the piece in clavichord, right?
Yes, I'm currently working on pretty extensively on clavichord, and I thought that this would be quite an appropriate piece for that instrument. Given that Haydn really came into contact with clavichords, and this was among the Auenmerger sonatas, the dynamics are quite unusual, so it sets it apart from the other five sonatas in the set. So it was clearly for an instrument with expressive potential.
going with the flow. The one thing I was immediately made aware of was that piece of technology, pedal, that took you just a moment to get used to, and you had that squeak, which was actually a perfect thing to happen.
Thus phrased as a change in an art world, changes of keyboard compass are technological drift as opposed to a revolution. If the contemporaries indeed thought this development to be logical steps within their tradition, this would help to explain why compass initially failed to shake up pianistic Vienna and to leave a consistent, well-visible trail in the documents. Both the fact that most of the discourse about keyboard ranges took place outside the written records and the assumption that it likely was about fashion and desirability rather than about musical values takes the edge of our fixation on composers' artistic intentions in matters of compass choice. A reinterpretation of compass as a fad that stayed helps the modern performer to address faithfulness to the musical text in Viennese keyboard music with a more relaxed attitude. Thank you.
So when Gilly told me he'd be playing this, he decided to ask me. I said, well, that's fine because Haydn composed in 1 hour. He proposes a fee to Atalia and he says, I know it's a lot of money, but it's kind of so schwierig. And many people have interpreted it as to, you can be puzzled by why is he calling it not difficult. One interpretation could be that it's not difficult, so therefore you can sell it and amateurs can play it. But the more likely explanation is that it's not difficult to engrave. It's not like the bagatelle that we had where it's yada. This is yada.
I see.
like turning your two hands into persons, I suppose.
Here they are. Well, enter more assertively.
Changes in articulations too, which do make sense against the backdrop of a change of instrument from